Buongiorno a tutti.
Dalla sua cucina a Origlia in Ontario, Raffaella Tulipano entra nelle case di tutto il mondo. È difatti diventata una star del web, una nonna youtuber che presenta le sue ricette in un perfetto tandem tra tradizione culinaria italiana e innovazione della comunicazione digitale.
Mi sento grata di tutto questo. Ho 82 anni. Sono contentissima.
Tutto è iniziato con la pandemia che ha confinato le nostre vite tra le mura domestiche. In casa Tulipano, cucinare, filmare e caricare video su internet è diventato un modo per occupare le giornate e soprattutto combattere la demenza senile, malattia con cui Raffaella convive da tempo.
It kept mom physically very active. As you can see from some of her videos, when you're making pasta and some of the sweets, there's a lot of muscles, if you will, that are involved in rolling the dough. And so it was a great way to exercise her mind, her body, and it kept her spirits up.
Se le cene in famiglia sono state sospese per via del Covid, Raffaella Tulipano non ha smesso di stare davanti ai fornelli e sfamare figli e nipoti.
For my mom, her language of love is food. You know, sempre dice mangia, mangia, devi mangiare. And so bringing this food that we prepare to our family members was exciting.
1, 2, 3.
A poco il popolo di internet si è accorto di Nonna Mia, così si chiama il canale YouTube, con le diverse generazioni della famiglia che hanno messo a disposizione le proprie abilità per far decollare questa avventura. La figlia Josie, videomaker ed editor, e i nipoti incaricati di gestire i social media.
Everybody in our family is responsible for, you know, sending the message, and we do a really great job, and Nonna Mia has been all over YouTube in that regard. So yeah, she's definitely been very popular in, you know, even people my age.
La fama di Nonna Mia si è rapidamente estesa fino a raggiungere l'Italia con la Rai che ha ospitato la YouTuber al programma Filo Rosso.
Mai potevo pensare una cosa così. E mentre che hanno fatto le fotografie a me a Roma, l'hanno messa alla televisione, mia cugina sta là e mi ha conosciuto. Subito ho fatto fotografie, l'ha mandata ai parenti al Brasile.
Un ritorno virtuale alle origini. 60 anni fa Tulipano lasciava Cosenza per cercare fortuna in Canada, con la notorietà che le ha permesso di rimettersi in contatto con parenti in diverse parti del mondo. A più di un anno dall'inizio di questa avventura culinaria sono una settantina i video online e i prossimi obiettivi sono chiari.
Piace arrivare a 100. Poi vorrei fare un libro.
Insomma, una storia positiva, fiorita in un anno orribile soprattutto per gli anziani, una generazione spazzata via dal Covid con molte famiglie che hanno vissuto un lutto e Nonna Mia è un po' diventata la nonna di tutti. Forse anche questo è il segreto del suo successo.
Who moved to Canada from Italy more than 56 years ago. She used this pandemic as an opportunity to turn her Aurelia kitchen into an Italian cookhouse. And as CTV's Alessandra Carniero reports, her recipes have made her a YouTube sensation.
With the COVID, we cannot go anywhere. And I decided to make wonderful stuff.
From her Aurelia kitchen, Raffaella Tulipano has found a way to keep busy during lockdown.
I love to cook. And for the family also, I love my kids.
But when the pandemic began, COVID-19 restrictions meant the 82-year-old nonna would be separated from most of her big Italian family. So her daughter had an idea to film her mother creating her favorite recipes and to share them online.
She loves cooking, she loves, you know, she's very generous. So this allowed her to cook up a storm. We'd record it so that the kids could have these recipes forever.
Yeah. All right.
Within a few months, the videos titled Nonna Mia generated thousands of views on YouTube, Facebook, and even TikTok.
That gave me satisfaction. Very, I'm proud of them also, they're young, and they try to make what I do.
And her popularity didn't stop there. Her cooking skills caught the attention of Italy's national public broadcaster, Rai, and led to an appearance on the network.
That's it.
She had all of her nieces and a bunch of family members calling her in tears with, you know, just how astounded they were to see her on TV. And she was just ecstatic.
What I say, to try to get busy like I do.
And while her love for cooking may take the cake, she says her message for others is simple.
I protect you and you protect me. Andrà tutto bene. Everything will be all right.
Alessandra Carnero, CTV News, Barrie.
Con un'altra notizia che riguarda una super nonna italiana, anzi una super nonna calabrese che vive in Canada e lei è diventata una vera e propria star del web. Guardiamo con attenzione questo filmato perché tra poco la mitica nonna Mia sarà in collegamento con noi. Guardate.
Buongiorno a tutti.
When the stars make you drool just like a pasta fazool at some more. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Excuse me, but you see back in old.
Whoa, that's amore. Look at that.
Che fama ci ha fatto venire, eccola qui, nonna Mia. Benvenuta.
Benvenuta a te. Buongiorno!
Buongiorno! Nonna Mia, presentaci subito queste belle ragazze che sono lì con te.
Gabriella, mia nipotina, e mia figlia, Josie.
Bene, benvenute anche a voi, che gioia avervi qua in collegamento. Senti, ma sei sorpresa che tanti italiani seguono i tuoi video? Tu ormai vivi in America da tanti anni, no?
Sì, sì.
Quanti anni sono che te ne sei andata dalla Calabria?
Certo.
Da quanti anni?
Sì, 60 di più.
70 di più.
Ma hai ancora l'accento calabrese, nonna mia. Io lo sento.
Grazie. Non si perde mai.
No, non si perde mai. Cosa ti manca di più dell'Italia? Dimmi la verità.
Le mie cugine siamo cresciute assieme.
Certo.
E i frutti, le fichi mi mancano.
I fichi, cioè, e il mare calabrese.
Sì.
Io so che Josie, tu parli molto bene italiano perché vieni spesso qui da noi, infatti vedo che ogni tanto traduci anche a nonna Mia, ma qual è il segreto del successo di nonna Mia, di questi suoi video che ormai sono seguitissimi?
La mamma carina, piace la sua gioia di vivere, la sua passione della cucina italiana e il suo stile, diciamo, adorabile.
È vero, è proprio così, infatti l'abbiamo notata anche noi. Gabriella, tu sei la nipotina di nonna Mia e da lei hai ereditato questa passione per la cucina. È vero che verrà in Italia a studiare?
Sì, quando potremo viaggiare, volerò in Italia per 6 mesi per studiare la cucina italiana e la lingua italiana.
Ma parlate benissimo tutti!
Thank you.
Grazie.
Nonna Mia, ma che stai cucinando davanti a quel pentolone?
Spaghetti con mettibolle, diciamo, in America. Faccio le polpette.
Le spaghetti con le polpette anche in Italia ci piacciono.
Sì.
Anche a me piacciono tanto. Nonna Mia, ti voglio fare una piccola sorpresa, no, un piccolo regalo, niente di che, una piccola cosa, però mi dici qual è la canzone italiana che preferisci, che hai nel cuore? Io vorrei fartela ascoltare.
Felicità, mi piace.
Albano e Romina. E allora eccola qui per nonna Mia, sua figlia e suo nipote. Felicità.
Oh, grazie.
E un bicchiere di vino con un panino la felicità.
Grazie.
È una piccola cosa per ricordarti la tua Italia. Allora, io ti devo salutare, ma prima voglio vedere gli spaghetti con le polpette.
Oh, mi dispiace che siete lontani, se no vi portavo questo piatto.
Se vieni in Italia ce li fai assaggiare. Grazie, grazie Gabriella, grazie Josy, grazie di essere stati con noi.
Grazie, grazie.
Ciao.
Ciao. Ciao.
Grazie, grazie.
But now we're going to connect with some friends of ours in Aurelia, and I have to say one thing. Don't ever let age stop you from ever doing anything, because nonna mia tells us differently. Ciao, grazie.
Buongiorno a tutti.
Buona domenica. So we've got, of course, the star, nonna mia, which is Raffaella, joining us, along with your daughter, nonna mia, your daughter Josy, and your grandson, Anthony.
My grandson.
Yes, yes. So you know what? I have to ask you, nonna mia, dimmi, let's start with this. Come ti è nata l'idea di iniziare un programma su YouTube? How did that happen?
Oh, c'è il COVID. È stato un bel passatempo perché passava il tempo. Non andava da nessuna parte. Così è stata.
Well, I mean, that's the beautiful thing is, you know, you found something to do when there was nothing to do. And it's obvious that you love, ti piace cucinare, sì?
Like, sì, sì, very much.
So I have to ask you, Josy, someone's behind that camera. Have you been, integral in getting these videos out there, Josy, or maybe it's Anthony?
Anthony actually started the YouTube channel. He actually created the account and the name Nonna Mia. I am the videographer, I guess, the director of Nonna Mia.
One of the things that's beautiful is that Nonna, tell me, I'm just going to call you Nonna because I feel like you're my Nonna right now. You're everybody's Nonna. is that this is, I mean, what's beautiful is it's connected generations. You have all come together and you're part of this process with your nonna. I mean, what a great experience. Tell us about that.
It's an unbelievable experience. And, you know, we've been saying for years now, we got to get Nonna on a cooking show to share recipes with the world. And on a more, you know, self-interested level, I've been saying to everybody that this is the best cook in the world. And so now I have some proof.
I love that. I love that. Now, you know, one of the things you mentioned, I don't know who mentioned it, but somebody wrote that this was like a time capsule of recipes because everything's documented now.
Yes, we're so grateful. It's wonderful that 20 years from now, our great-granddaughters will be able to make Nonna's recipes in Nonna, like when Erica made the scallops.
Yes! My granddaughter already made it.
Beautiful. Well, you know, speaking of your granddaughter, Nonna, we saw one of your earlier videos. I saw your granddaughter outside because you were actually starting off with tips to deal with COVID. And I thought it was so interesting because you would say, listen to me, please. Tips to staying home during COVID. Is that where it all kind of started and led into the cooking?
It is, yes. Nonna started giving tips. We were really just having fun. Yeah. Never imagined that it would spin off like this. And now she has 82 videos, Nonna.
yes.
You know, and a dream come true. I understand that you made it to Rai in Italia, sì? Is that true?
You're on Rai, Nonna.
Yes.
It was incredible. Oh. We had family members from Brazil.
Yeah.
Brazil, America, all over, Canada, America, incredible.
what a star. Anthony, what were you saying?
Well, I was just going to say, we even got people emailing asking for the Nonna Mia signature apron.
See, look at that. You're marketing some product now. You got some merch, as my daughter tells me. I want some merch. Nonna Mia, are you cooking something there? What do you have?
I do some gnocchi.
Oh.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little bit about your gnocchi? Yeah.
So what are we going to do, Nonna?
So she does a potato-based gnocchi. Why don't you show Andrea your cutting and your rolling?
Yeah.
We caught it. And then you roll it.
And then you roll it. Beautiful. And yeah. Nonna, you're from Cosenza, sì, in Calabria.
Yeah, sì,
Calabrese.
Cosenza,
that's right. Well, I want to thank you so much for coming on. You know, I have to tell you too, Josie, one of the things I was reading is, you know, with our grandparents, they really had a tough time during COVID and they needed things to do. We wanted to do things with them to keep them, you know, keep them going. This has been doing that for your mom, yes?
Oh, it's been brilliant. The amount of connection that is created with the immediate family and extended family and the community of fans, it's been tremendous. It really encourages Nona and motivates her every day. And she's like, okay, let's do it. And so we've been really inspired to see what an 82-year-old can do. Her energy is astounding and her passion for her family and for Italian food is tremendous. I mean, she showcased here her homemade sausage. Nonno makes the wine. We get the sausages here. I mean, family and food has spanned our three generations, and we get together every year to make all of this homemade.
That's right. Well, I want to thank you, Nonna Mia, for joining us. Josie, thank you. And Anthony, you're so lucky to have such an awesome Nonna and to have her there with you. That's such a blessing. And yeah, can you give your Nonna a hug for me? Give her a big hug for me, for all of us watching, how much we wish we could hug our Nonnas right now. You're doing that on behalf of all of us. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Arrivederci, Nonna Mia.
Is one of the nicest people in the world, but man, is she a mean cook. Now she has taken over YouTube with her weekly recipes. We are so glad to welcome the glamorous, the gorgeous, the great Nonna Mia live with her amazing daughter, Josie. Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Okay, can we talk about the fact that Rai TV is the staple institution of all things television in Italy, and Nonna Mia was on it. What was that like?
Thank you for letting us come on your show. Thank you.
Okay, so you have a YouTube channel, Nonna Mia, but today we're going to make cannoli. What makes a good cannoli?
Yes, I made it this morning. Look at this. Beautiful.
Ooh, beautiful. How do we make it?
Chocolate and pistachio, two kinds.
So we're going to show her how to make them today.
Yeah. I can show you how to make.
Come si fa? Okay, let's go. Ricotta? You need some fresh ricotta?
Ice and sugar. And zest of lemon.
That's one whole lemon rind. Is it half a cup of icing sugar, is it?
That's a half a cup of icing sugar and yes, lemon rind. Yeah.
Fresca. There's the ingredients.
Just a blender, just a hand stir.
Yeah.
Why do you love cooking, Nonna?
See, and here I have it ready in the glass already.
Oh, smart.
And I can fill it up.
Brava.
And that's why do you like cooking?
I love it. I like to do that. So for my children, my kids, I have 7 grandchildren. I love them. Sometimes I even brag to them when I cook.
5 kids, amazing. And all the grandkids, it's all about family, food. So once you're done mixing it, put it in a bag, Ziploc bag or whatever, and you squeeze it into the cannoli. And you could buy the shells anywhere, right?
Yeah, the ones that we made this morning.
This was a fresh.
This fresca, one. Fresca.
I made it myself. Yeah. And then fill it up.
Here you go. Beautiful. She made those. She's amazing. Okay, so this YouTube channel, who comes up with all the recipes? Is it Nonna's recipes that she shares with the world?
known as recipes, but they all time like our for meets or a girlfriend or family from Italy. So yeah, she's got lots of people supporting her with ideas.
Yeah.
What a beautiful family. She's a star. She's a star. Modelista over here. So then you either put pistachios or chocolate chips, and you could put them in the fridge. They're even better the next day. We have Sid Sixero here. He loves to eat cannoli. He's married to an Italian, Lucy. Sid Sixero, you have a Nonna Mia apron on. And you know what else, Sid?
You know what I'm
saying? Nonna Mia, look, I even wore my Forza Azzurri slippers for you. Azzurri! That's right, Sid. That's right. You're very close to some Forza Azzurri Italian slippers right now. Where do we find more information? Where do we watch Nonna cook it up?
So her YouTube channel is just Nonna Mia, but she's also on Facebook and TikTok and Instagram.
Okay, Nonna Mia, what is your secret to a happy, long life?
Love, I guess.
Love, and we love Nonna Mia.
Love.
Tanti baci, we love you, Nonna Mia. Keep cooking, keep smiling, and love to your family. And tarantella, when all else fails. Oh, Nonna, we have a graphic for you because they call me Nonna. So let's see the graphic. Do we have it? Do we have the graphic? It's Nonna, Nonna, new cooking show. Hey. Grazie, Sai. Have a great day. This is amazing. A YouTube channel.
Thank you.
82 years young, loves to cook, starts up a YouTube channel, which shows there's nothing you can't do. We need to be like Nonna Mia. We'll be back with more BT right after this. Hey!
I made it this morning fresh.
Hailing from Calabria, Italy, Raffaella Tulipano loves to cook and make people laugh.
I pass the time and I help people. It's incredible. People love it, watch me, what I say, what I do, and that's great.
It was early last year her family started a YouTube page to help keep her engaged. But what it became was something much more.
It's actually become an incredible way for Nonna to keep busy, to keep active, to stay inspired, and to feel like there's a purpose each day.
It's something helpful for people. And I remind their Nonna, the grandma, and doing this, and they're so happy.
And that's how a YouTube star was born.
Buongiorno a tutti. Buongiorno a tutti. Buongiorno a tutti.
Buongiorno tutti Nonna Mia, a YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram cooking phenomenon with decades of experience in Italian cuisine to share.
Let's start. Yeah.
This is Nonna Mia in her kitchen.
The family has helped her create nearly 90 episodes, starting out with pandemic tips, but then realized Italian cooking was what the masses wanted. Just short little bites, giving you a taste of what Italy can be.
I'm so happy that I make them happy.
Anthony, one of her 7 grandchildren, helped her set up the page. He says seeing her enjoy it so much is what makes it worth it, along with enjoying the food as well.
For us to be able to watch Nonna Mia's videos online, to remember all the times I had the food that she's making when I was a child, it's truly special.
Her goal is to reach 100 episodes and eventually create a cookbook, a milestone she's confident she can reach.
I got time, 82 years old. I'm free.
Fraser Snowden, Global News.